Hi everyone, thank you so much for joining us. Today I have my mom with me again. Let me scoot closer.
Oh, I thought you were going to help you.
And so yeah, I asked my mom to be in this video with me today. And we want to talk a little bit about period care and I guess not so much like how to take care of yourself when you're on your period. I think that'll be another video because that can be very detailed. But with this one, we're talking about like how to take care of yourself.
What's better.
Yeah, what's better to use when you're bleeding, basically. And so the reason why I wanted to talk about this is because there are a lot of different options nowadays. And unfortunately, some of these options can be harmful to our bodies. And yes. I think that it's not really known the different ways that these types of things can affect us. So, what are we talking about specifically? I guess pads, yes. Tampons. There's also the Diva Cup nowadays.
Right. There are so many things that people are using. Mm-hmm. But I think over the years, you know, we were taught, at least when I was growing up, mm-hmm. I grew up in Africa, and so
in Somalia.
Yes, I am from Somalia, but we didn't have these pads or tampons and all of those kind of things.
So you didn't even have pads?
No. Okay. When I was growing up, we didn't have it. And it was maybe they were just starting by the time I left up about 28 years ago. Mm-hmm. And so we would just cut sheets, mm-hmm. you know, just a piece of sheets, and we always had them ready. And we put them on, and when they were dirty, we just took them out. We washed them. We would use them again next month.
Yeah.
And those, I think using those kind of sheets, or now when I came here, it was easy for them.
Yeah, because you can dispose of them, which we'll talk about a little bit too. There's a book that I'm reading right now, and the woman who wrote it is from China, and she was talking mm-hmm. about how before she got her period, her mom had like a stack of, I think it was like rice sheets. Oh. And so it was basically like cloth, and her mom taught her how to wrap it on her underwear and to be able to use those cloths, and you would just wash it.
I think it's more natural that way. People are not used to it, but the pads, these days, they have toxins.
Yeah, that's the thing. So the pads...
It's hurting your body. It's also the environment.
Yeah.
They never... somehow.
Yeah, especially the pads that have a lot of plastic on them. Mm-hmm. So some have more plastic lining and stuff like that to make sure there isn't any leakage, which is nice and it's convenient for us. But at the same time, we have to kind of think about where that's going in mm-hmm. on the planet and how it's affecting the planet. And is it going to decompose? It's not. I mean, if it does, it's going to take so many years. It'll take a really long time. And
you have to think about the future and the environment. But some people will say, I don't care the environment, this is easy, grab and go. Mm-hmm. But think about it, what is it doing to your body?
Yeah, so exactly, like how is it affecting your body?
And
so
a lot of chemicals.
With a lot of the companies, they use all types of different chemicals on the pads to make sure that they're white, to make sure that they're
good.
Yeah, and so, but no one really takes into consideration.
And it's going inside your body, and it's causing you a lot of problems, a lot of infections, a lot of other diseases that you don't want to get it, and so think about it. So for us, we searched, we were like, what are we going to do? How are we going to take care of ourselves and our, you know, neighbors, our children, and, you know, all of this.
And to help other women.
Before we show them what we use, also, I was traveling a week ago, and they were given these free things, and I thought, what is this? And it said, no chemical.
Yeah. So this is a tampon, and actually,
I took
it. You can see what it looks like. I don't know if it'll focus. This is what it looks like. And actually, right now, when my mom just brought it,
I had it in my purse.
When she brought it to show me, I was like, "What is that?" And she was like,
"I didn't open it. We didn't open it, but she was this. It was given to me, but it was just given to every woman to try it because you can stick it up there." Can you imagine sticking up there? What is it doing to you?
I don't know, but there are a lot of people who feel comfortable with using that. And so we're not judging, but at the same time, there's
but
a little bit of
information. But what is it doing?
I'm
definitely not judging, but I'm saying sit down. Take a few minutes and say, what is this really doing?
Yeah.
So that's it. Putting anything in there, you are jamming in
And things have to come out.
Yeah. So
let's get
so
into...
So in from the Ayurvedic perspective, as well as from the Chinese medicine perspective, there's a downward flow that needs to happen when you're on your period. Mm-hmm. And so there has to be this energetic flow of going downwards. And so to have anything going upwards at the same time with that downward energy, there's a blockage there, and it doesn't support your body in cleansing during the time of your period. It just goes against it. And a lot of us deal with things like cramps and irregular periods and things like that, and those can happen from basically the stuckness that happens there. And that can be due to using things that are going against the flow, and that way there's more buildup in the uterus, and then it just becomes more difficult for the uterus to fully cleanse out. So it's really important to think about, if using tampons is something that you are used to, just to keep this into consideration when you're deciding to use tampons, to understand that they're not everything might be able to come out. It might be very difficult for your body to completely cleanse having something in there blocking that. Mm-hmm. And so then people will ask, well, what is the solution, or what is it that that we use? And so my
right.
mom has
some people have a heavy flow or overnight, so we have a reusable pads. These are made of just cloth, and believe me, they are just like same thing, but you just wash it, you hang it, that's it, you reuse it. So these are like the large, some people like it and say, oh, I want an overnight ones.
Or for people who experience heavy bleeding,
so
they can use these.
Yeah, and then we have these medium-sized ones. You can wear them during the day or whatever works for you. But you just open it, and you just wrap it in your underpants. And
so it looks
really
exactly
it.
Like
a pad. Yeah, exactly. So ladies out there, we have so many options to take care of our body and ourselves.
Yeah, and I think, like, for me, when I first thought about using cloth pads, I thought it was really, I didn't even want to try it, and it took me a long time to try. Actually, my mom gave me some of these, and I had it in the closet, and I was like, every time I was like, I don't even want to try it. It just sounded so, I don't know. But then finally,
we're not used to it, that's why.
Yeah, we're not used to it. And so finally, one day I did try it, and it just feels like they're not too much, they're not super thick, and so it's not like it doesn't feel super uncomfortable or anything like that.
Yeah.
I guess, I don't know, it just becomes comfortable, especially if you, if you're able to create some type of routine for yourself, so that you have, like, if you're out a lot or if you're working a lot.
I have a friend who uses them. She said when she's at school or at work, she has a Ziploc in her purse.
Oh.
And she has an extra ones in her purse.
Yeah.
She goes, she said, I'm in the office. When I need to change it, I just take it and I just wrap it up.
Oh.
And put it in my bag when I get home. She said, I wash it, I hang them.
Yeah.
I wash my bag, I dry it during the day. In the morning, then she said, I have a dry ones and I take them.
Yeah.
How important it is to you. Some people go, that's gross, this is not gross. What's gross is if you get infection with those other pads, you can get in trouble. There was a model, girl, beautiful girl, they had to cut her leg because of some infection that she got from the pads.
Or
the tampons or
her
something.
Her body may have just been super sensitive.
It was her, yeah. But what about if it's one of us and another girl, that we don't want that to keep happening to us women. We already have enough to carry in the world.
Yeah.
So we don't want it. Whatever, you can make it easy for yourself. So these are what we are recommending today, and it's found it on our website.
Yes, so we'll put my mom's website in the description box where you can, she sells these of different sizes, and so you can purchase them through there. And then I just want to say, for me, it took me a little while to transition, and sometimes it's even where, like, if you're traveling or something, you're not able to do this, so what is another option? And so for me, one thing that I feel comfortable with is using pads that are, like, there's this one company, I can't remember the name of it, but they don't use any chemicals. They use organic cotton mm-hmm. on there too. So it's like, it's a much better option to use compared to things that are more mainstream and have the chemicals
right.
included. So to just work with yourself and to have this in mind mm-hmm. and to try to maybe even transition slowly somehow. And so it's really
right.
nice to just kind of know that you have options.
And also, I think it's not only us moms or girls, also babies. You use diaper cloth for your baby. Yeah, and when, like this week when you're traveling, so when you're traveling also, you buy those.
Yeah, there are diapers that have, they're like non-toxic, they don't use
chloric. Something
like
that.
There's like different chemicals that they use in the diapers, and so I try to make sure that I buy the most natural ones.
And the environment too.
Yeah,
so
yeah.
It's
there are some that are like compostable, not compostable. You don't want to put them with your food when you're composting and stuff. But they are like it's not as. It is a little bit more environmentally
friendly.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So. So it's important to keep these types of things in mind. Also,
yeah.
I don't think we talked too much about the Diva Cup, or the I don't know. The Diva Cup is a specific company.
I'm sorry,
that
guys, you
them.
All out there, but I cannot imagine
using the cup.
For me, I'm talking about me. I cannot imagine taking. Oh, love, Sabrina. Taking. It's not this big or anything, but it's like a plastic and putting it in there. I'm like, how do people do it? But some people love it. Absolutely
yeah.
love it.
Yeah, for some people it works. And I
yeah.
and that is something that is, I guess it doesn't have the chemical maybe aspect of it, and it is more environmentally friendly. However,
it
if you think about that downward flow that I was explaining before, it kind of goes against that, because although the cup is catching everything
coming,
that
yeah.
that your uterus is shedding out, it is still against your flow because
mm-hmm.
it's in there. And so so that can then become something that blocks you from being able to fully cleanse and have
yeah.
a healthy period. So these are just some ideas, and these are just something to talk about. We just
yeah,
wanted to share about it and let you know that there are different options out there for you.
And young girls, don't be afraid to use these. I literally have 13-year-old, 14-year-old who just uses these and said, I don't know anything else, because she knows it's better for her.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and
for her future, for her health.
It's like anything in life. It just, once you try something new and you figure out that it's better for you, and you just, it's something that's not super difficult or anything,
right.
it ends up becoming something that you, that you're able to do and that you just get used to.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, you would get used to it.
Cool. Yeah. So thank you so much.
Yes, thank you for having me. This is nice. I love talking about these ladies' stuff.
I know. I love it too. All
please,
of this womanhood type
yeah,
things.
Yeah, please share the videos and show other ladies and give the video a thumbs up and subscribe. Share this kind of videos. It's important
yeah.
for us ladies. So.
Yeah. Take care.
Yeah,
bye.
Have a wonderful day.